Hey guys, it's Kimberly from Keep the Tail Wagging, and today was shopping day for the dogs. And so I am going to show you what I bought for them. I went to two stores, Walmart and Costco, and so I'm going to handle each store one at a time. So store one, Walmart. I go to Walmart because they have a lot of the things that I need. They have ghee. Can you believe that? I can't find it anywhere else except for Walmart. They also have grass-fed butter. I'm starting to see it in a lot of other places, but it's cheapest at Walmart. And Walmart is the only place that I can go to get canned oysters. I do not want to order these online because buying canned products online is expensive shipping. And so what I do is I walk into Walmart super early in the morning because I don't really like going to the store too often because it gets so crazy crowded sometimes. So I go in there super early in the morning and I buy these. These are Pacific Pearls. They're the ones that are the lowest in the sodium. And I buy about 24, 25 cans. These are boiled in water, not smoked. I never give my dog smoked foods because I worry about the toxins. I split one can of these every week to week and a half. So my 24, 25 cans will last me a while. And my dogs will just get an equal amount into here. I don't worry about how much they weigh. My dogs weigh between 65 and 83 pounds. So I figure, close enough. The reason why I add oysters to my dog's diet is because oysters are rich in zinc, selenium, manganese, I believe vitamin D, definitely vitamin B12, protein and iron and a bunch of other nutrients. And so, yay, yummy. Oh, omega-3 fatty acids. I do not add oysters and fish in the same meal because they don't need all of that. But sometimes if I forgot to thaw things out, that could happen. Another thing I pick up at Walmart, Kerrygold grass-fed butter. This little stick of butter, I guess it's not that little, is just under $3 a pack. But it's the cheapest that I found in the city. Everywhere else is super expensive or they don't have the unsalted. This is unsalted. I really want my dogs to have grass-fed butter because I figure that it's healthier for them than just getting them any old regular butter. And so I am adding this to my girls' meal because I am trying to get them into ketosis. So I'm slowly increasing the amount of fat to their diet and decreasing the protein to offset that because I want them to put their body in a place where they're burning more fat and losing weight. I know that this is controversial and I know that there are people who have a problem with dogs being on a keto diet. I have done my homework. I am working with people. I have educated myself. And if it doesn't work, it's not something that I would continue. When it comes to putting your dogs on a keto diet, it's something that you want to cycle on and cycle off. So my dogs will do it for up to 120 days and then they'll go back to normal. And in the meantime, my dogs are eating less food. They are exercising. It's not like I'm just counting on the keto diet to help them lose weight. And that being said, I picked up a blood glucose meter. So this is a meter. These are the strips. I spent less than $20 on both of these together. So that was my trip. Oh, one more thing. Organic olive oil. This was a really great deal, $5. So I went ahead and picked that up as well, just to have an oil or a fat alternative, you know, if I didn't thaw out the butter or just wanted to give the dog some variety. Costco. At Costco, I needed eggs. I'm almost out. So I buy an 18 carton, I think that's what this is called, of organic, certified organic, grass-fed, free-range. I don't know if chickens eat grass, but you know, free range eggs. And I bought four of these for my dogs. It will take me a couple months to go through all those eggs, I think. My dogs get eggs, one each every other day, up to 4 days a week. Another thing I bought at Costco were vegetables. I spent $20 on vegetables. So $5 for asparagus, $5 for green beans, and $10 for mixed greens. This is kale, spinach, and baby chard. I also have broccoli that I had already purchased in the fridge. Together, it's going to be the next fermented process, and I'll be starting that tomorrow. And finally, at Costco, Costaquin DS Plus with MSM was on sale. Tomorrow is the last day, so by the time you see this video, this sale will be over, at least at our Costco. I can buy this for about $35 plus shipping on Amazon.com. I think it runs about $50 at the vet's office. It's $27 at Costco. So I bought four of them. It's limit two per person. So I bought two, then went back to my car, put everything in, went back in, bought two more. And then I'm buying two more tomorrow, or I should say four more tomorrow. A good friend of mine, Dr. Lori Kosher, she was kind enough to remind me that when you get a really good deal, check the expiration date. So I did that. And these expire in 2021, so we're good to go. That is such amazing advice because I actually made the mistake two times of taking advantage of an amazing deal only to find that the food had not only expired, but it made my dog sick. So it's very important to understand that although some things, when it has an expiration date, it's really not that big of a deal, there are other things where it can be a big deal. So definitely look at the expiration date because as I understand it, the potency of the supplement may not be as good if it's past expiration. And as a side note, for people who are wondering, why in the world are you giving this to your dogs? You know, they're raw fed. Because it works. I noticed that Sydney was moving a little slower, getting up a little slower, having some joint pain despite what I was giving her. And I spoke to her veterinarian about it, and her veterinarian said this: 2 days after being on this, along with Canine System Saver, I will never take her off of that supplement. She was back to her normal self. So both Sydney and Rodrigo are on this supplement simply because they both have a history of joint pain. Rodrigo started his joint pain started before he was 2 years old. Sydney was when she was 2 years old. Plus, Sydney has the history of the partial cruciate tear. So I just don't like to see my dogs in pain. Scout and Zoe, they are on a supplement called Enclover Connectin, and that is perfect for them, great for maintenance. They are young, spry, healthy. They don't technically need a joint supplement, but I just really believe that because they're active and jumping around all the time, I definitely want them to have that support, so that's why they get Connectin. So that is today's shopping video. I hope it was helpful. I will put a list of everything I purchased in the notes, as well as any pertinent links that you may need. Thank you for watching. Talk to you later.